Hi, I'm Sian from Kiro, and with me today is Daniel from Spanish Property Expert. Thank you for joining me, Daniel.
Hi, Sian. How are you?
Really good, thank you. Okay, tell me a bit about you, Daniel.
I am the director of Spanish Property Expert. I've been in the field for many, many years. We started initially in 2010. Formerly, I used to work in America in Miami. I was trained by Remax. And I came here in a holiday many, many years ago, and I realized there is a market here. And I start my business on my own. Initially, we were Spanish property repossession. And we've done repossession after the last recession. And that was our main expertise, repossession properties. And we've done repossession properties all over the world, not only in Spain. I'm an international broker. I have an office in the UK and I have an office in Dubai. But I'm in love with Spain and I love the market. I love the culture. I love everything here. So I focus mainly in Spanish market.
Nice. Thank you. And tell me more about your agency, Spanish Property Expert.
Spanish Property Expert, I designed the agency myself. So we try to be as dynamic as possible and we try to make sense in everything what we are doing. We have cooperation with many builders, with many other estate agencies in Spain. And we try to focus from as far as Barcelona to as far as Malaga and inland. So if a client is approaching one of our properties, so basically we are searching properties which we think make sense in terms of investment, in terms of rentals, in terms of reselling value. And, you know, so we focus on those properties. So we select those properties. We promote these properties to our clients. Our clients is contacting us and we take them, we travel with them to the properties, or one of our agents is going to go with them, or myself, I'm going to go with them, or our partners is going to travel with them. So if a client wants a property, for example, in Barcelona, we have an agency there, which we work with. We were going to go with the client with that agency and introduce you to the property. Obviously, we have to pre-qualify the client before, because as I said, it needs to make sense. We're not just going to go with the client just for the sake of seeing a property. Like, you know, we need to get closer with the client as and to understand his needs in terms of the property, to understand his investment, if he's an investor or if he's buying it for himself. So we have a different approach than most of the companies in Spain. We are not like a local estate agent, which we have property next to our door. We are international brokers. We travel with clients from cities to cities, places to places. And in the end, 90% of our clients, if they follow our step ABC, they're going to end up with a good bargain, with a good property. Mm-hmm. And usually that creates our database of clients as well, because a satisfied client with us within 3, 4, 5 years is going to resell the property with us again. So that's kind of the way we run our business. Like, you know.
Yeah, thank you, Daniel. Tell me more about the clients that you're talking about. Who are your buyers?
It formerly used to be a lot of Brits, Irish. I am very well connected with Ireland myself, and I do a lot of events in Ireland as well. But at the moment, since the Brexit, the whole thing changed. And we start to see a lot of Americans being interested here, a lot of Canadians, North countries mainly, you know, so we have French, we have Belgium, Germans, still Irish and Brits, they're coming. I would say this year and last year, more Irish than Brits, like, you know, but still not drastically changes from the years before, like, you know, but Americans, I'm surprised about Americans, and Americans, they have the habit of buying properties from us over the phone. So they never come to see the properties.
Wow.
We provide them with all the information. We provide them with all the legal. We have solicitors on board. So they give power of attorneys and we do virtual videos, calls, or we facilitate every sort of information they need. And they buying over the phone. Yeah. Last week, I sold the property to a guy from India who bought the property over the phone as well. So it's amazing the amount of properties lately we sold over the phone without our clients coming over, you know. Yes. So, and they're buying it over the phone, and within 2 to 3 years, they're selling it over the phone as well. So we act on instruction, like, you know, they give us instructions on what to do, like, you know.
Yeah.
And also, we provide the biggest help is our experience in this field. So we give them all the information and we let them in the end to take the decision. But most of our investors, they work with our experience. So they're using us for our experience being in this business for almost 15 years. They're kind of trusting us. Trust is a big element in our business.
Absolutely. And remote viewings are working really well then. That's really good.
They do work very well, very well. To be honest with you, we insist in photography, in videos. We do our own videos, our own photography, and we look at the details. Details makes the difference in this business. So most of our videos, what we create, shows exactly the reality what the client would buy. And the clients, they look at the figures as well. We try to push like a return investment between 5 to 10%. Depends on the property, depends on many factors, so some of the most of our clients, they're looking at those figures as well, and if the figures adds up for them, they're happy, so
That's great. Tell me, what's your biggest challenge right now, Daniel?
The biggest challenge right now, it's when you get clients, for example, they just, for it happens many, many times when a client approaches us and they said, I would like to see this property. And usually we send out a set of questions because we need to get to know the client before we do any inspections. Otherwise, we're going to waste a lot of time, a lot of money in doing nothing. And most of the clients, they want to get educated, but they do not have the money. They have something to sell or they have a property to sell, and they believe their property is going to sell very quick and they need to see properties before they sell theirs. But I always say to the clients, you are in the better position you have when you have the money in your bank account than going to see a property and not having the money. And a lot of people does that, where they come here in holidays and they just want to do a research, but they don't understand, we are agents. For us, time is important. And the way we are running our business, we're going from A to B, we can do 400 kilometers in one day. So imagine to do that for somebody who is not in the position to buy the property. And it's a personal thing for a client as well. And sometimes they kind of do have the tendency to take offense, because they seems like, I'm not good to you if I don't have the money. Everybody's welcome to us, but it has to make sense. You go to those property shows and the client is approaching you and he says, when would you like to buy a property? Within 4 years. Why we are talking? So that's, a lot of people are like that. Lately it happened that a lot, and that probably is one of my challenges, because I try to put it in the nicest way to a client. Look, that's the way you should do it, without any offense, without anything. That's one of my challenges, I would say, and that's kind of, but a part of that, there's no challenges. We do everything, so
yeah, great.
We are experts, in everything. Yeah.
I speak to many agents, and there really is a divide. Many agents are saying exactly what you're saying, that they only want qualified buyers with money in their account ready to buy. And we also get loads of agents that say they just want to fill up their database, and then they're adding all buyers of any interest to a database and they're emailing them out. Would you not find that a way of working, or is that, have you
the way I run the business and the way we do it more personal. For me, numbers doesn't really matter. For me, what it matters is one-to-one approach.
So I
have clients where they probably approached me 5 years ago at the place in the Sancho or any other exhibition, and they still in touch with me, and they're in touch with me as in they have my personal number. They text me on WhatsApp day and night, and we speak, but one-to-one for me is more important than sending a lot of emails out, and you may get a reply, you may not get a reply. Or with those emails, sometimes what I notice, you get to annoy the clients more. When you are flooded with all these emails, the clients, they don't like that. So I'm not the type of guy what I'm going to go there reaching for a client. I offer my services and I let the client to approach me, a lot of people, they send me emails. They said, email only, do not call me. So obviously there are other agents out there where they do a very aggressive marketing technique, which we're not. I am far too busy to be on the phone to someone constantly to hassle him to buy a property. And I will never do that, because my philosophy is very simple. Treat everybody the way you want to be treated yourself. So if any client is looking to buy a property, he's going to research us. If he's happy with my services, he's going to work with me. If he's not happy, he can go to work with anybody else. You know, yeah. We're not insisting on anything. But, you know.
Yeah, yeah. That's fair enough, Daniel. And there's no right and wrong way of doing it, is there? It's just really interesting to see different people's business models and their strategies to get that buyer to buy one of their properties. Yeah. Thank you. What about what's exciting you most in the industry right now?
I love the business I've been doing this business for 15 years now, and I love the business. Every day is totally different. There is no 2 days the same. And every day you meet different people, different characters, different views, different people. They have different ways of looking at the same thing from a different angle. And it's very interactive. It's every morning when I wake up, I can't wait to wake up to go in front of the computer to start my business. It's not, for me, it's not work. It's just come natural to me. Like, you know, and I love it. I love every single aspect of this business. Like, you know, so, right. And I love, the most exciting part is, to be honest with you, is when I handle the keys to a client and you see his happiness on his face. And there are clients there which for them is a big, big step to buy any type of property, especially abroad. And when you see that happiness and that excitement in their faces and that joy, it excites me as well. It's like an energy coming to me as well. Like, you know, it's an amazing feeling, and it cannot be described. Like, you know, and it happens a lot. You know, I'm fortunate to happen a lot, actually.
Yeah, no, that's amazing. Really, really amazing. Yeah. One thing I'm hearing a lot of lately is agents are telling us that they're getting less inquiries overall, but the conversion rate of those inquiries are a lot better, a lot higher. So sort of quality over quantity. Is that what you're...
I never focus on the quantity. I always focus on the quality. The conversion rate for us always has been good from the day one.
Yeah, great.
So we never had periods of times. Yes, there was a period of time, if I recall, after the Brexit, when the phone stopped ringing. Physically, it stopped ringing. That was a period of time. And after the first lockdown, that was scary, I must say. But amount into it, we didn't panic. We didn't do anything. We just wait. And the market start to readjust himself.
Yeah.
The pandemic was such an experience in my view, because when we are in lockdown, we are communicating a lot and we will figure out our ways. And we didn't do any sales. But when the things start to ease off, I would say in 2021 and 2022 was the best 2 years in business for myself.
Wow.
I mean, 2021... we're doing some sort of we help clients with rentals as well, and we were looking. The Spanish couldn't travel abroad, so they were focusing in their own countries, and as never before, the Spanish people become our number one client in buying properties, which it blew my mind completely, and was the best year in business for me, 2021 and 2022. You know, so. It's, as I said, I don't focus on volumes of people. I focus on people, what they are open, what they understand, what they are open mind. You know, that kind of people I'm focusing on. Like, you know, and they are willing to look from different angles at the thing. Like, you know, so that's.
No, thank you. That's really, really useful. Thank you, Daniel.
Yeah.
That brings me to the end. So thank you for joining me. Been really nice.
It was a pleasure.
And we'll keep in touch. Thank you.
I must say, it's a pleasure working with you guys. We've been working together for many, many years, and it's always a pleasure. For me, Kiero is number one. So it's in my heart. So I think it's always going to be there. Like, you know, I hope it's always going to be there.
Oh, thank you, Daniel.
It was a pleasure talking to you again.
It's been a pleasure working with you too. I really enjoy our email exchanges. It's always fun and lighthearted, isn't it? Thank you. Really important. Thank you very much, Daniel. Have a great day. Speak soon.
You too. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.